can do some examples of equilibrium. And in particular, we're very fond of, physicists are very fond of giving a ladder problems. So here you have a ladder which is resting against the ground and it's resting against the wall in the other direction. And you don't want the ladder to move. You want it to be in equilibrium. If the ladder slips or if it rotates, you have a problem, right? So we often like to study the conditions of equilibrium for this. And when you do that, what you are going to assume is that you have friction provided by this ground here. So this ground is rough, it's always going to provide friction. If your ladder slides, it's going to slide this way, which means your frictional force is going to be in the opposite direction this way. Remember, friction we usually write with lowercase f. Here's my ladder, it's at a 60 degree angle that's given to us, and the entire length of the ladder is L, which means that about half L over 2 is where my weight of the ladder is acting, yeah? Let's say it's the mass M times G, that's the weight of the ladder is acting at this. So this is the line of action of this force. If I want to consider the torque due to this, I'm going to extend the line, so this is my line of action. If it rotates, it's going to rotate about this pivot point, right? So the entire ladder may rotate like that. Axis of rotation is out of this page, in or out from this point. So this is going to be, from that point to here, is my distance r, which I'm interested in. That's going to tell me the torque, mg times this distance r, yeah? In this case, in this question, we're going to label it d2, so I'm just going to change that r to d2. So we're going to write that distance as the distance d2. Okay. Now, if the ladder is resting against the ground, there must be a normal reaction on the ground. So I'm going to call that my normal reaction n. Yeah? And in fact, let's call that N1, because there's also a reaction from this wall on here. And the normal reaction, remember, is always perpendicular to the surface from which the reaction is generated. And I'm going to call that N2, yeah? Okay, so now we have, do we have a torque due to N1? No, because it's going through this point here. There is no R, R is zero, so this produces no torque, yeah? Similarly, the friction produces no torque. It's also going through this point. But this will produce a torque. So what's the distance of this line of action of this force if I extend it here? And that's a straight line there. That's my line of action. And this distance here, let's choose a different color so that we can show this. So I'm not going to be able to draw a dashed line, but I'll just draw a line which is hopefully supposed to be perpendicular here. This distance is my distance r to the line of action of the force, and I'm going to call that distance d1, okay? So d1 times this normal force n2 is going to be the torque produced due to n2, which is in this counterclockwise direction, yeah? Any other forces? Any other torques? No, we have taken into account all the forces. So just showing this more neatly is exactly the next diagram. Here's my weight mg acting downwards. In this case, it happens to be 50 newtons. Okay, let's say the problem gave you that. Here are the two normal reactions. Here's the frictional force. So four forces, these two are acting at the axis of rotation. I'm going to take that as my origin. So neither of these produce a torque. This one and this one produce a torque. In this case, I have used not resolving components of the forces to get the torques, but taking the line of action of the force and finding the lever arm to it is just easier for me to see that, yeah? So this is the line of action of the force. Here is the lever arm for this one. Here's the line of action of this force. Drop a perpendicular from your axis of rotation, which is this. So that's d1, okay? And then you need to apply your conditions, your equilibrium conditions, right? So if we consider the conditions in the x direction, yeah, then we have summation of F component forces or F direction forces must equal zero. And what are those forces? in the x direction, if I take x to be the horizontal direction, then we have the frictional force, F. Yeah. This has no component in the x direction. This has no component. These are vertical. And so P, this must be equal to the normal force P, which I called N2 in mine. Okay. And remember, the normal force is mu times mg. Yeah? We did this when we were learning about friction. So this is my first equation. What about the y direction? The y direction is the vertical direction, okay? So I didn't actually say that anywhere. Maybe I can draw my directions here, that this is the x direction and this is the y direction, same as along here, okay? This is the y direction. Okay, so now for forces in the y direction, we have N1, yeah, which is this one, N1. And we have, this must be balanced by the weight, yeah? I'm just going to write that as mg, since 50 newtons might be specific to this problem, okay? No other vertical forces. And then, so this is my summation Fy equals zero. That's where this came from, yeah? And then the third condition is going to come from the torque, which is summation of torque equals zero. So I need to consider the torque due to this. What is the torque due to this? We said it is, first of all, let's consider if it's going to be positive or negative. This is going to make it rotate in this direction, which is clockwise. So it's going to be negative mg times the distance d2. And this one's going to produce a counterclockwise motion, so it's positive, N2, dy, equals zero. And you should eliminate N2 from here and substitute this as mu times mg, okay? So that you have fewer variables. Okay, so let's now look at this more neatly in the next slide and talk you through it now that you've learned how to do it. So I'm going to do one problem for you, and then there's a follow-on problem that you're going to do on your own. Okay, it's quite an easy problem. So a 50 kg ladder leans against a frictionless wall at 60 degree angle. What is the minimum force of friction needed to prevent the ladder from sliding? Assume that the ground does provide friction. So we're going to assume that we have friction here, yeah? No friction here, okay? So what are my forces? We have the same four forces. We have frictional force. We have normal reaction N1. We have normal reaction N2. We have somewhere there, center of the ladder. We have mg acting downwards, yeah? And what are my lever arms? It's this distance here, yeah, which I labeled earlier, I think, as D1. So let's work out that D1. A 5 is given as 60 degrees. Yeah, this is occurring at L over 2. So L over 2 times cosine 60 degrees, that must be this distance here. L over 2 times cosine 60 degrees. You need to be able to work this distance out the way I did. This is a right triangle. I just resolved for this. I used trigonometry to get this, yeah? I know that this side, hypotenuse side, is L over 2. So this must be L over 2 cosine 60. If you're not able to do this, you need to practice several problems. This is the line of action of this one. I need this distance from the axis of rotation. This is going to be my distance D2, and what is that going to be? It's going to be L sine phi or sine 60 degrees, yeah? And now that I have written out all this, you need to work out those three equations in terms of these values, right? The conditions fx, summation fx equals zero, summation fy equals zero, summation of torque equals zero. And then you need to solve those equations. So let's look at that happening now. Here are my four forces. Okay. Here's the same diagram, a little less neat. Okay. Three conditions. The first condition boils down to N2, which is the frictional force equals mu mg. Second one, N1 equals mg. And this is the third one for the torque. Okay. And then now you're going to solve these to find the value of N2, which is your normal force. Let's go back to the problem and see what they asked us for. What is the minimum force of friction needed to prevent the ladder from sliding? So we have N2. We have found the value of N2. We know that N2 is related to the coefficient of friction, yeah, times mg. So N2 is the same as the frictional force. Yeah. Sometimes the question might not ask you for the frictional force. It might ask you to find this coefficient. So you have to use the fact that they are related to find the value of mu, since you know mg. So you should do this problem and you should check that you get your frictional force as 141.45. In fact, here I got the value of mu. This was not asked for in this problem, but I actually did it. Okay. So the next problem is exactly similar and you are going to do this yourself. In this case, it's a 50 degree angle and I'm not going to talk you through it. It's best that you try to make this diagram on your own as you go through. And try to solve the problem. Just compare your results with mine.